Kitchen Kerf. Today we will be discussing sardines. You knew it was coming. I get tons of questions on sardines, and I want you all to be brave enough to try them, because there's really nothing scary about them. If you like tuna, if you like salmon, if you eat seafood in general, I promise that you will love sardines. We have two cans here today. These are just packed in oil. And I actually noticed that it's soybean oil, and I would much prefer them to be in olive oil. I actually had a brand that was in lemon olive oil that I really, really loved. So I didn't buy these. My husband bought these. But if you're looking for them, I would get some in olive oil. You could also just get them packed in water if you're trying to have a little lighter version. Totally fine. Sardines are packed with calcium, vitamin D, vitamin B12, and omega-3s, all nutrients that none of us get enough of. So it's a great superfood, in my opinion. I have already opened up one of my cans. Oh, and the smoked variety is amazing. These are the smoked variety. And then I'm just going to show you how you open them. Of course, this is the most fun part. So much more exciting than opening a can of tuna. And yes, they do smell fishy because they are fish. But it's just not a big deal. So you'll see that there is some juices in there. And here's my little garbage bowl. And I actually pulled this all the way off. But I just kind of go like this. And I drain all the oil out, like so. You don't have to get it all out because you do want some for moisture. So this is what they look like. Little fish. There is not heads on them, but yes, there are bones. You can see that little white thing sticking out right there is a bone. But the bones are not crunchy. It should not crunch. It's more of like cartilage. It's almost like, a celery stalk or something, but actually it doesn't crunch. That's a bad example. But anyways, it doesn't crunch. So this is the worst part, is looking at them. I usually just dump them out like that. And then you just mash them up. So it's kind of a gross process, but I recommend that you do not look. I don't like for them to look like fish. So I mash them completely until it looks like tuna salad. I call them fancy tuna salad because it's butterier and richer than tuna salad is. But just keep mashing until you kind of get it all up. And then, you know, this is just tuna. I mean, if you eat tuna, then you eat the same thing. You just don't see it in its fish form. So you can mash and mash and mash as much as you want. But that's a pretty good job. So over here I have my vegetables, carrots, green bell pepper, and that is not red onion. That is actually a purple bell pepper. So I will add these to the bowl. You really could add like any kind of vegetables you want. I would say maybe that's like a cup and a half or so. And then just kind of mush those around. And then I've got some mayonnaise made with olive oil, and you don't have to use mayonnaise. You could use Greek yogurt, you could just use mustard, but I think that, you know, just like, I would say that's maybe like half a tablespoon for the whole bowl is good enough. I love mustard, so I always add a lot of mustard. Oh gosh. You want it to be kind of moist, so a really good addition to this is capers and pickles. Sorry about that. Then I add a little bit of sea salt, just like that. And then the secret ingredient to my seafood salad, salmon, tuna, or sardine, is red curry powder. So I would add a hearty teaspoon, like so. You could also do dill style, is really good. And then you just mix this all together. And then you can spread it onto a sandwich or onto crackers. You can eat it with veggies or chips. Tortilla chips is really good. And there you have it. So now, that doesn't really look like fish at all, does it? It just looks like a fancy tuna salad. Thank you for paying a visit to Kitchen Kerf.